Sierra Leone is recovering from the Ebola outbreak that clearly laid bare the lapses in the health services. The lack of qualified practicing medical practitioners is one key factor that has over the years hindered the delivery of health services. To support the health recovery process, Sierra Leoneans in the diaspora teamed up with the Mahmoud Idris Foundation and other partners to deliver free medical and surgical services in Bou, south of Sierra Leone.
We know Sierra Leone has suffered from the Ebola crisis, and we're diaspora members who are eager to give back and be part of the health reconstruction, the health system strengthening, and so we're here to give back.
It's a medical mission that aims to provide medical and surgical services to people who are desperately in need, but as well cannot afford to pay what the market is going for. So in essence, it's a free medical and surgical services that are being offered.
Government is making a lot of efforts actually to improve the healthcare delivery system in the country. But the government cannot do it alone, single-handedly. So we actually depend on partners to come in at very crucial moments to come and support the government. And this came at the right time.
I've been working in South Africa for the past 5 years. So I was contacted by a friend of mine, Josephine Kame. So I told her I was going to make it possible to be part of this team. So as you rightly said, I'm prepped up and preparing to enter the operating theater.
Dr. Georges Boele is the lead surgeon of the team. He also serves on the Pacha Foundation board.
We came with a small team of my group. We came with we are two surgeons, one assistant of surgeon, and two anesthetists, a nurse and a doctor. And we want to give the best of our time and of our practice according to the information that the local doctor can give us.
I don't been getting money. They up to now, I don't get money to do that. Only thing, we are not Canada, we don't go do this free medical affair for me. I feel happiness inside my lifetime. From since, I don't get the kind of happiness yet. From today, I don't get good happiness now. Today, inside my lifetime, where they don't do this one for me.
This is the and I want the money out. Only the money out will affect them. They already hurt. They vomit. Now, in the first person, somebody can do the operation, I'll be happy. I'll be happy so much because the sick don't understand it. Because the sick, they make you not the eat.
Today we have 100 patients. We already have for today more than 35 or 40 surgery that we will perform. So that show the needs. And I think during the other days, the number will increase.
People are so much in need, and I don't think this 1 week really cuts it. It's the beginning. We were focusing a lot on the training. We've seen over 1,500 people. We've done 127 surgeries as of yesterday. The need is great. People need the health system here is great, but there's a lot of, you know, we've lost a lot of doctors. The doctors here are doing amazing work. Nurses are amazing, but they're not that many.
With support from the Ministry of Health and Sanitation, the Haley Foundation, Kingsway Charity, IMC, Ascovim, the medical mission donated drugs to 8 health facilities in Freetown, Bou, and Pujon.
Well, we have a small group of diaspora members that are very committed, so we all sort of chipped in. We have some donations from a few organizations like AmeriCares, Brother to Brother Foundation, IMRES, even from local groups here, the Mahmoud Idris Foundation, from Fawaz Building Materials, and the rest we personally paid for ourselves. So we decided that we wanted to make this happen and that we could be the change that we wish to see. So we were willing to give that sacrifice and sponsor it ourselves.
In partnership with Jala University, approximately 75 community health officers and 35 nurses were trained on infectious diseases prevention and control and emergency medical services.
Quite a lot of training activity also went on, training in infection prevention and control, training in emergency medical services, and a host of other medical and surgical protocols. We have some people from the College of Medicine, the university, who are also using this mission to do hands-on training and learning what they're doing in the class as well.
Our part on the team is to bring some trauma training, emergency life-saving training to the organization, to the group, to bring out here to Bow, train the community health officers and the nurses in how to administer some of this life-saving training. Some of the subjects are new, so I do think it will make a difference in some of the new research that we're able to bring here and show them some very basic but very effective techniques.
Although this is their first international mission, Dr. Georges Boyle, a CNN hero, and his team do monthly free medical and educational mission to remote villages in Cameroon.
I think this is just the beginning. It's our first time to come here and we have a look and we saw the needs. And Josephine already promised us to bring us in a remote village than Bo. Bo is so nice. They have a big hospital. I'm happy that the government do the effort to have this kind of hospital here. But I'm sure that in the remote village, they still have a lot of needs. So Josephine already promised us to bring us in the remote villages. So I'm waiting to come next time with a team bigger than this one.
In 10 days, the diaspora medical team successfully did 187 surgeries, provided primary healthcare screening and services and triage to over 2,059 people in Bow, some of whom came from other districts including Freetown, Joué, Makeni, Pujon, Kono, Kenema, and other areas in the country. The team also trained approximately 75 community health officers and 35 nurses in emergency medical services and did refresher training for over 25 nurses in infectious disease prevention and control. The team also gave hands-on surgical training to approximately 20 student community health officers and 3 newly graduated house officers who are medical doctors.
So what we wanted to do is build capacity. The medical mission is great, but it's like a band-aid solution if you do not train people, if you do not train the local doctors and nurses and encourage those, even the community health workers, community health officers. So we've worked with the university, we've worked with the hospitals, with the School of Medicine to really train those young doctors to see what we're doing so that when we leave, these are the doctors that are now going to provide the kind of services we're looking for. These are the doctors that are now skilled, that have the techniques we're bringing in.
Imparting knowledge on someone and helping them to see things a little differently is always successful. And so now it's on them to implement some of the things that they've been taught. And it's incumbent on us to sort of follow through and see that, yeah, those things are working or they're not working, or we need to do more training or assist in some way in developing how they can implement these things.
We need to come once in a while actually to provide this necessary training for them. But at times, say, because we are overwhelmed with activities in the Ministry of Health and Sanitation, we have no time for those things. So those trainings they actually provided help us very, very greatly.
To further support and strengthen the health system in Sierra Leone, the Sierra Leone Medical Diaspora Team donated laboratory supplies, medical supplies, and medicines to the Bow Government Hospital, Gila Children and Community Hospital in Bow, Mercy Hospital in Bow, Children's Hospital in Bow, Paramedical School of Health Sciences, Bow, Emergency Hospital in Freetown, Rokopu Hospital in Freetown, and Pujon Government Hospital.
We saw the needs are great. You know, we need an ENT specialist, an ENT surgeon. We need orthopedic surgeons. So looking at where those gaps are and how we could bring those specialists and make sure that the facilities are prepared for them as well. So we're ready. We're going to go back immediately and start working on the next mission.